This is a Thor News presentation. Thor News presents You're right, sir.
Astros are close.
It's like 3 or 5 fireballs. Everybody knows you can't get hurt by something if it's in the bag. Welcome to the latest edition of Asteroid Fight Club. I'm your host, Thor Durden, and in this episode, I am super confused. I don't know what the hell is going on with asteroids, man. I covered this for a year like a champion. I felt like I got a hot stick in the butt and a scar to show it. After a year of dedication, could I get a tweet from any of the premier asteroid scientists? Hell no. Did they make any sense? Hell no. Did NASA start talking about the dangers of asteroids? Hell yeah! They weren't talking about blowing up asteroids. They were talking about capturing an asteroid. Like, oh my god, we've got a 12-mile asteroid headed towards Earth. It's gonna destroy us. What do you wanna do? They were like, capture it, put a bag around it? Yeah, that sounds like a great idea. Let's put a bag around it. Everybody knows you can't get hurt by something if it's in the bag. So, just the other day, I turned on my space weather. Just the other day being yesterday. It's like 305 fireballs. And I'm like, whoop, whoop. Sound the confused alarm. Sound it now. You got 305 fireballs. And you got an asteroid. 2014. It just shows up out of nowhere. 0.1 lunar distance, which is close enough that no debugger can even say, hell no, that ain't close. And then, nobody really talks about that one, but this one coming up, asteroid 2014, RC Cola Radio Control Doom. Close approach to Earth, September 7th, 2014, brought to you by, that's right, P-Chode Ass, from the NASA Jet Propulsion Lab. This Sunday, weekend, asteroid flyby, so throw a party. Make some moonshine, or just mix Kool-Aid with the alcohol of your choice. This Sunday, a house-sized asteroid named 2014 RC will fly through the Earth-Moon system almost inside the orbit of geosynchronous satellites. Over New Zealand, or that's 25,000 miles to you non-metric mofos. This diagram from NASA shows the geometry of the encounter. Could an asteroid kill a billion people? Yes. Could an asteroid wipe out a city? Absolutely. Could an asteroid kill you? You bet your unsweet Bippy Johnny is science and the media mentally conflicted with mixed signals on the subject of asteroid and asteroid danger? Absolutely. But hey, it is a fudged up, wacky, wonked out world. So up is down, down is up, dead is money, bad is good, and I'm single. Surprise! Johnny, get out of here. I'm tired of talking to you. There ain't no Johnny. There is no danger of a collision with Earth. Great science knows everything. Ultimately, even though there are possible dangers, there's never really any danger. Do you understand? Me neither. So let's keep moving. Asteroid 2014 RC Radio Control Doom was discovered on the night of August 31st when two astronomers were making out by a telescope. One bumped in a moment of orgasm, looked through the scope, and saw a speck of doom hurtling our way. At the Catalina Sky Survey near Tucson, Arizona, that lover couple independently detected the next night by the Pan-STARRS 1 telescope, coincidentally, where two more astronomers were making out, and that one was located on the summit of Hale Akala, Maui, Hawaii. The closest approach is space rock offers researchers an opportunity for point-blank studies of a near-Earth asteroid. Point-blank, huh? Even amateur astronomers who are the forefront, they are the soldier, the Air Force, the Navy, the Marines, the National Guard, the Army of Asteroid Defense. Your government fears asteroids so much, it put it in the hands of the people. Like here, climate change is too much for us to deal with. We don't have the energy and time to worry about asteroids, asteroid danger, warnings, crap like that. You guys, you people take care of it. But put it as a lower priority than making money, paying your taxes, because I don't know if you taxpayers know this, you guys owe your government a lot of money. Like, if you had bills, I don't think all the cars in the world could hold all the money we owe. Who again? Who do we owe the money to? I forget. But this is not about economics. This is about asteroids. Follow-up observations quickly confirm the orbit of 2014 RC. It comes from just beyond the orbit of Mars. close approach to this space rock offers researchers an opportunity for the public studies of all this. Even amateur astronomers will be able to track it. I don't know. I think Bruce Gary's busy. Oh, that's a good colonizing joke. They went to golf now. Around the time of its closest approach, it will brighten to magnitude plus 11.5 as it zips through the constellation Pisces. So imagine like a little fishy swimming by the window of Earth in our little solar system aquarium. This means it will be invisible to the naked eye, but if you put some clothes on your eyes, you might be able to see it with a backyard telescope. Though, do not buy a telescope too big, or NASA will start tracking you. It'll let people have big telescopes. I made all that up because I thought I'd lead to a funny place with it, but I could not. According to NASA, the orbit of 2014 RC will bring it back to our planet's neighborhood in the near future. Awesome. The asteroid's future motion will be closely monitored. Awesome. But no future threatening Earth encounters have been identified. Awesome. Here we are. We're passed by two stories about the sun. Because we all know the sun doesn't affect anything. So, it don't matter. Man, I'm in a weird mood, huh? So, yesterday there were 305 fireballs, which I was like, wow, that's weird, considering there's no major meteor shower going on. And that's still a large number even for a large meteor shower. And today, we only have 38 fireballs. And in my opinion, most of them seem to be coming from, like, this area. The fireballs are all, it's like, high and inclined. You know. It's like, fireballs, if they were sliding down a ladder. I like it when I make no sense. Alright. So, on yesterday's chart, what happened? They add RC to this, but this number did not go up. You guys are bad at math, lazy, or disingenuous. That's okay, because I'm a comedian. And none of this makes any sense. But hey, it's 2014. We're all supposed to be crazy. And then, I'll cover more of this crap later, but this is interesting. This is interesting. Between September 19th and October 7th, just in this little window, we've got 1, 2, 3, 4. Asteroids larger than a kilometer. And one of them is asteroid 2014 NE52. And that's interesting because NASA estimated a couple years ago that they had found 93% of all asteroids larger than 1 kilometer. And as I've been pointing out slowly through my videos, pretty sure their math is off. So once again, that brings me circularly back to The pros kind of talk about asteroids' danger, but then they really act like they don't care at all. Why journalists are like, yeah, that's all woo, like asteroid danger and Nibiru or conspiracy theories by crazy people who live in their mom's basement eating Nutella all day and stuff sponges in a jar of mustard to masturbate. And I'm like, my universe today, why you dudes got weird? You know? You guys gotten weird. You know? Almost as weird as our own government. Airglow! What the F? We're going over to the universe today. Yeah, I had a story on sprites, gravity waves, and airglow. Remember, it's normal. Even if aliens descend from the sky in a spaceship, take your family, your gold, and your gasoline, and then take off with your right hand and your left eyeball. That's normal. Don't complain, just go to work, pay your taxes. I don't see no sprites. Oh, there's still. Okay, over at the universe today, we got Bob King, Mr. Senior, seniority at universe today, saying, get ready for Sunday's close flyby of asteroid 2014. RC. First of all, if you can't see it with the telescope, and there's a 100% chance it's not going to affect us, why do people have to get ready? Get ready for something that won't affect you at all. You know, it'd be like saying, hey, get ready for dark matter. You won't be able to smell it, see it, touch it, feel it, but get ready for it. Okay? Sounds great. Okay, so you know, here's the article. Guess who's dropping by for a quick visit this weekend? It should be guess what is dropping by for a quick visit this weekend. And dropping implies height and that it's coming down. On Sunday, 60-foot wide, 20 meters, asteroid named 2014 RC will skim just 25,000 miles from Earth. That's within spinning distance of all those geosynchronous communication weather satellites orbiting at 22,300 miles. Hey, there's a Solomon's number. The Earth is just a big canoe. Obi-Wan Kenobi. Alright, right now we're taking a look at 2014 Raw. Alright, right now we're taking a look at 2014 Raw. Now, you're saying, why are we looking at 2014 Raw? And I'm saying, because, yesterday, it passed within 0.1 lunar distances between Earth and outer space. It was close. It wasn't very big, but they only host it. I'm the first. And I believe it had it. R.A. was found in the first. Last observed on the second. Goes into the Mars. Sarah's region. Which is out here. Should we get one of those fun 6.0 E negative 4 AUs? 0.001. What does this mean? Does anybody know? I don't know. 40 E negative 4 AU? Alright. So that's the one that just passed. This is the house asteroid that is, house asteroid party. And then this is 2014 RC Cola. Radio controlled. Asteroid. Ooh, it gets down to a 3.0 E-4. And it stays there for 2 hours. Very interesting. 9/7/2014.